Universidad Austral de Chile. Libertas Capitur. La libertad se conquista.
The Grammar Translation Method. Grammar translation is a way of studying a language that approaches the language first through detailed analysis of its grammar rules, followed by application of this knowledge to the task of translating sentences and texts into and out of the target language. Accuracy is emphasized. Reading and writing are the major focus. Little or no systematic attention is paid to speaking or listening. Grammar is taught deductively, that is, by presentation and study of grammar rules, which are then practiced through translation exercises. The student's native language is the medium of instruction. It is used to explain new items and to enable comparisons to be made between the foreign language and the student's native language. It is a method for which there is no theory. There is no literature that offers a rationale or justification for it or that attempts to relate it to issues in linguistics, psychology, or educational theory. Toward the mid-19th century, several factors contributed to a questioning and rejection of the grammar translation method. Those factors were related to the need of opportunities for communication among Europeans created a demand for oral proficiency in foreign languages. Audiolingual method. This combination of structural linguistic theory, contrastive analysis, oral-oral procedures, and behaviorist psychology led to the audiolingual method. Audiolingualism as a term was coined by Professor Nelson Brooks in 1964. He claimed that this language teaching transformation from an art to a science would enable learners to achieve mastery of a foreign language effectively and efficiently. Language was viewed as a system of structurally related elements for the encoding of meaning, the elements being phonemes, morphemes, words, structures, and sentence types. The term structural referred to these characteristics. Elements in a language were thought of as being linearly produced in a rule-governed, structured way. Language samples could be exhaustively described at any structural level of description, phonetic, phonemic, morphological, etc. Linguistic levels were thought of as systems within systems, that is, as being pyramidally structured. Phonemic systems led to morphemic systems, and these in turn led to the higher level systems of phrases, clauses, and sentences. The phonological and grammatical systems of the language constitute the organization of language and by implication the units of production and comprehension. The grammatical system consists of a listing of grammatical elements and rules for their linear combination into words, phrases, and sentences. Rule-ordered processes involve addition, deletion, and transposition of elements. Theory of learning. The language teaching theoreticians and methodologists who developed audiolingualism not only had a convincing and powerful theory of language to draw upon, but they were also working in a period when a prominent school of American psychology, known as behavioral psychology, claimed to have tapped the secrets of all human learning, including language learning. Psychological foundations of audiolingualism. Foreign language learning is basically a process of mechanical habit formation. Language skills are learned more effectively if the items to be learned in the target language are presented in spoken form before they are seen in written form. Analogy provides a better foundation for language learning than analysis. Analogy involves the processes of generalization and discrimination. The meanings that the words of a language have for the native speaker can be learned only in a linguistic and cultural context and not in isolation. Design. These immediate objectives imply three others. First, control of the structures of sound, form, and order in the new language. Second, acquaintance with vocabulary items that bring content into these structures. And third, meaning, in terms of the significance these verbal symbols have for those who speak the language natively. Brooks, 1964, page 113. The syllabus. The starting point is a linguistic syllabus, which contains the key items of phonology, morphology, and syntax of the language arranged according to their order of presentation. types of learning and teaching activities. Dialogues and drills form the basis of audiolingual classroom practices. Learner roles. Learners are viewed as organisms that can be directed by skilled training techniques to produce correct responses. Teacher roles. The teacher's role is central and active. It is a teacher-dominated method. The role of instructional materials. Instructional materials in the audiolingual method assist the teacher to develop language mastery in the learner. Procedure. In a typical audiolingual lesson, the following procedures would be observed. 1. Students first hear a model dialogue containing the key structures that are the focus of the lesson. They repeat each line of the dialogue, individually and in chorus. The teacher pays attention to pronunciation, intonation, and fluency. Correction of mistakes of pronunciation or grammar is direct and immediate. The dialogue is memorized gradually, line by line. A line may be broken down into several phrases if necessary. The dialogue is read aloud in chorus, one half saying one speaker's part and the other half responding. The students do not consult their book throughout this phase. 2. The dialogue is adapted to the student's interest or situation, through changing certain key words or phrases. This is acted out by the students. 3. Certain key structures from the dialogue are selected and used as the basis for pattern drills of different kinds. These are first practiced in chorus and then individually. 4. The students may refer to their textbook, and follow up reading, writing, or vocabulary activities based on the dialogue may be introduced. At the beginning level, writing is purely imitative and consists of little more than copying out sentences that have been practiced. As proficiency increases, students may write out variations of structural items they have practiced or write short compositions on given topics with the help of framing questions, which will guide their use of the language.
Universidad Austral de Chile. Libertas Capitur. La libertad se conquista.